Hi everyone, this is topic 3 of the human anatomy class, and this topic will introduce you to tissues. The study of tissues is known as histology. So what is a tissue made up of? A tissue consists of cells and a non-cellular part which is known as the extracellular matrix or the ECM. The ECM in turn is made up of two components, the ground substance and the extracellular protein fibers. In human body, there are four main categories of tissue: epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and neural tissue. This figure illustrates how cells and extracellular materials and fluids make up or they combine to form the four types of tissues in human body. We will start with muscular tissue. Muscular tissue is made up of muscles, and the most important characteristic or feature of the muscular tissue is its ability to contract and relax. That means to shorten and to extend or elongate. And this ability helps muscles to generate movement. Muscular tissue is made up of muscle cells as well as extracellular matrix. There are three types of muscle cells in human body: skeletal muscle, smooth muscle, and cardiac muscle. Now, muscular tissue is associated with specific terminology. For example, the cytoplasm inside of a muscle cell is known as sarcoplasm. The plasma lemma or the plasma membrane is called the sarcolemma. The endoplasmic reticulum is known as sarcoplasmic reticulum. So you see the repetition of the term sarco. Sarco means flesh. Skeletal muscle is also known as striated muscle because it looks striped or striated if you look at the histological section of a muscle under the microscope. Location of striated muscle is all over the body attached to the skeleton. Shape is long, cylindrical, rope-like, and that's why a muscle cell is also known as a muscle fiber. It has more than one nucleus, therefore muscle cells are multinucleated, and very important, skeletal muscles are voluntary. That means they are under your conscious control. For example, whenever you want to move your hand, you can move it. So this is under conscious control. This figure shows the shape of the skeletal muscle. Look at it. It is long, tube-like, and the stripes, the vertical stripes, which are the striations, and you can see that one cell has more than one nucleus. The nuclei are shown in blue color. The second type of muscle in human body is smooth muscle. From the name itself, this muscle appears to be smooth. It does not have striations. So it is known as non-striated muscle. Location: this muscle type is usually present in the walls of hollow organs inside your body, for example, your stomach. Regarding the shape, it is spindle-shaped and the ends are tapering. Nucleus is only one nucleus per cell, so it is known as uninucleate. Regarding the mode of action, smooth muscle cells are involuntary. That means they are not under your conscious control. For example, you cannot command your stomach muscle to start churning the food. Look at the figure of the smooth muscle here. The cells are spindle-shaped. There's only one nucleus. The nucleus is shown in blue color and there are no stripes. The third type of muscle is cardiac muscle. The name itself suggests that this muscle is found only inside your heart. As far as the shape is concerned, the cells are short. They are not as long as skeletal muscles and they are branched, which is something very different from skeletal muscle or smooth muscle. And adjacent cardiac muscle cells are connected by junctions. Those are known as intercalated discs. When you do the lab, these intercalated discs will look like zigzag lines, vertical lines. Mode of action: they are involuntary, they are striated, and each cardiac cell has just one nucleus. So it is uninucleate. This figure shows the histology of cardiac muscle. We are done with muscular tissue, so we move on to neural or nervous tissue. This tissue makes up your nervous system. That means it makes up your brain, your spinal cord, and your nerves. The most important feature of this type of tissue is its ability to conduct or transmit electrical signals, that means nerve impulses, throughout the body. Nervous tissue is made up of cells as well as extracellular matrix. There are two types of cells in the nervous tissue. The first one is neuron and the second one is neuroglia. Neurons are nerve cells. These are cells that are actually generating the electrical signals, that are transmitting the electrical signals. These are the longest cells in the body. Neuroglia is a collection of different types of cells. It's a pool of cells present in the nervous tissue, and their main function is to protect and nourish the neurons. This figure shows the histology of a part of a nerve cell or a neuron. So neurons, which are the main cells of the nervous tissue, these are the longest cells in your body, and they do not undergo mitosis. There is no cell reproduction here. That means the total number of neurons you have are produced during the fetal stage or early in infancy. A typical neuron consists of an expanded region, which is known as the soma or the cyton or the cell body. And there are some cell processes which extend out of the soma. There can be multiple short branching processes, which are known as dendrites. And there could be one long tail-like process, which is known as the axon. So this figure shows a neuron. The blue-colored structure is the neuron. You can see on the right side, the expanded part, which is the broad part, is the soma or the cell body. And the cell body has nucleus. And in the nucleus, you can see nucleolus. Then the short processes, multiple processes, which are present on all the sides of the cell body, those are the dendrites. And these processes receive information for the neuron. And then on the opposite side, there's one long tail-like process going out or leaving the cell body. This is known as the axon, and the axon transmits the signal away from the neuron. This slide discusses the effects of aging on the different tissue types in our body. And actually, from this lecture on, in the subsequent lectures, at the end of each lecture, we would have a slide that would discuss the effects of aging on that particular organ system. So as a person ages, in general, the repair process and the maintenance becomes less and less efficient. Okay, now this could vary from person to person. Your genes and your lifestyle play a very important role in determining how much or how soon aging would affect the person. But in general, the epithelial tissue becomes thinner. That means your skin becomes thin. When the skin becomes thin, that means you are getting less protection. The connective tissue is more prone to breaking. It becomes fragile. And since cardiac muscle cells and your nerve cells, they do not regenerate, there is no mitosis. That means if there is any kind of damage or just the usual wear and tear that occurs during the life process, these all get collected and they could cause major changes or major effects in the long run. And this leads to adverse health effects.